Hey, this is Morgan with Do Even Today. Today we're going to talk about personalizing your PC as another video in the How To PC series. The quickest and easiest way to start personalizing your PC is to go anywhere on your desktop right here, right click, say personalize. This takes you right to the settings that we want to configure. I'm going to go ahead and show you the long route real quick though, so that you know. You click on the start menu down here. The bottom left-hand corner, go to the settings icon and then click personalization. It gets you to the same place. For a background, you can choose solid color like I have, and I set a custom color that is a dark gray. You can select a picture. They have inbuilt pictures, or you could browse. It takes you right to your pictures folder. And you can add a custom one of your own. I like my solid color, so I'm gonna leave it. That's as a background. If you go to colors here, this lets you choose what you want your accent color to be. That's the color that shows up here behind these icons and a few other places in the Windows operating system. You can change your lock screen. The Windows Spotlight changes periodically. It is normally very pretty scenery that Microsoft has picked out to show you on your lock screen here. And your lock screen is normally not up that often anyway. You can do the same thing here. You can choose a picture slideshow of your own, or you can add a picture of your own, or select one of their inbuilt pictures as well. Here on this, you can also choose applications that you want a quick status on. Such as email or show you how many emails you currently have, if you have any currently pending events. You can also add things like an alarm clock or messaging, things like that. Themes. I use themes less often. You can create a custom theme, which is what I have going here, just by selecting background and colors. If not, they kind of have these. Choose from, a pre-configured background with a start bar color. To me, it's not as personal as I like for it to be, so I normally just select my own stuff. You have a few more options here. Normally, I take off this occasionally to show suggestions. I definitely make sure that this use start in full screen is off, unless if you're using a tablet. And most of the other things I leave here. I do like my recent apps to be shown. So it is, I do change a couple of these settings though. And your taskbar, some people like for their taskbar to be in different spots. You can actually move it to the side, or things like that. I definitely prefer mine at the bottom. That's how where I'm most familiar with it, but it is possible to move it to either side, top or bottom. So this is Morgan with Do Even Tech. We'll see you again in the next video.